Good day to you all. The case study on the primary English language education in Anuradhapura district. I am Mr. Lankumaran. Content of this study: introduction, research problem, research objectives, methodology, results and discussion, conclusion. Introduction. It is highly believed among the stakeholders that the quality of primary education impacts on the students' performance in their secondary, junior secondary, advanced level, and tertiary levels of education in the country. English, both as a curriculum subject and a second language, is taught in Sri Lankan schools from primary classes. For that, activity-based oral English has been introduced from grade one, while students learn English formally from grade three. That researchers confirm that all language planning activities take place in particular sociolinguistic setting, and the nature of scope of the planning can only be fully understood in relation to the settings. The government of Sri Lanka also initiate a number of projects time to time considering the above factors for primary education. Further, educational philosophers empathize that growth of a child should be according to the nature. According to this statement, when the education is not provided concerning this concept, it would not be a good harvest in English language at the final stage. The students can get the right education when the teachers give full support to the policy on primary English language education. Research problem. According to the discussion made with the teacher trainee students of HND in English program, the problem was identified and confirmed that the teachers are directing irrelevant methods in the primary education. It is confirmed that the primary teachers show and inefficient in providing English language education, since either the teaching methodology or awareness of the teachers does not fall in line with certain thoughts of educational philosophers regarding child education. Research objectives. The primary objective of this study is to analyze the ways how English is taught to primary students in Anuradhapura district. The secondary objective is to find out the awareness of teachers in terms of teaching English as a second language and to suggest the correct ways for teachers to set an ideal atmosphere to facilitate learning and acquiring English during one's childhood period. The methodology. The present study focuses the practices followed by the teachers in the primary teaching and their awareness on the methods of teaching. The study mostly conducted on the qualitative approach. The entire population of the study covers the Anuradhapura district. The 11 teachers in Anuradhapura district have been selected using random sampling method for the purpose of this study. Data collection tools such as observation, interview, focus group discussion, and questionnaire were used to collect the data. The statistical techniques such as frequency and percentage were used for the analysis and comparison of the practices.
Thank you, Mr. Veeralankumar. I'm Mr. Achyutan. Research and discussion. Role of English at students' enrollments. Out of sample primary teachers, 36.3% of respondents that they had tested English language skills, and 63.6 answered they had not tested the skills of the students at the enrollment in grade one. It is contrary to how the English language should be introduced to beginner learners formally in Sri Lanka. This will create a demand for the students to learn those skills before they go to school, which is neither a parallel with what educational philosophers suggest about a child's growth, nor the concept of curriculum developers in Sri Lanka. Teacher awareness towards language acquisition and language learning. 36.3, 54% and 9% of the teachers responded that they start teaching English in their school for grade 1, 3, and 4 respectively. It shows that the teachers do not have a uniformity in introducing the language to their students, which reveals the difficulties faced by the teachers in the concepts of language acquisition and learning. Teachers in class methodology. The teacher administered activities such as introducing dialogues, use polite expressions and greetings correctly, talk about daily actions, ask to tell the time, counting up to 10, describing action, simple dialogues, etc. in the primary classes. The observation shows that teachers give more writing to teach the writing skills than all the other skills which make the passive learners in the class. Among the above, listening to commands and responses and responding to simple questions are seen the listening practices in an authentic atmosphere, while all the other activities show the listening environment created by the teacher. The teachers were not able to reveal any remedial teaching activities to enhance the reading skills of the below average learners. The responses of the teachers revealed their inefficiency in employing such techniques in any specific circumstances. Activities given as homework. The nature of homeworks given by the teacher matches with the philosopher's thoughts regarding child education. Further, memorizing words for dictation plays a major technique to teach vocabulary. Challenges faced by the primary teachers. The problems such as shyness, anxiety, students forget to do homework since their rate of writing is low, they do not complete the work on time, smartness of the students, overworkload for teachers, slow learners, lack of technical equipment, overcrowded classroom, and time management are some to mention as challenges in Anuradhapura district. Conclusion. In summary, the teachers and schools in Anuradhapura district show irregularity in introducing the English language to their beginner learners. Though the teachers are aware on the various teaching methods and techniques of each language skills, the unconsciousness about the concepts such as language acquisition and learning in the context of second language learning, the primary English language education is not provided according to the natural growth of a child. On the other hand, this study shows that the primary English language teachers should be trained and their feedback should be taken as raw materials for planning and decision making regarding English language education in the district. This is the end of the presentation. Thank you.